qualify for match number two of the Hero CPL 2020 from the Brian Lara Cricket Academy in South Trinidad. Defending champions, the Barbados Tridents, taking on the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots. A reminder of the format for this season, with the teams playing each other twice in the league stage. The top four will qualify for the semi-finals, where first will play third, fourth, and second play third. Remember the playoff situation that they've had in the previous years, and 23 matches at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy, 10 at the Queen's Park Oval. Toss fell in favor of Riyad Emirates and the Patriots, and he chose to field first. And for the Tridents, Johnson Charles, Shea Hope is in there as the wicketkeeper. Corey Anderson into the Barbados Tridents franchise this year, and familiar faces of Carter, Holder, Nurse, and Reefer. Don't forget Rashid Khan and Mitchell Santner. For the Patriots, missing Fabian Allen, but they've got Chris Lynn, Evan Lewis, Ben Dunk, and Dinesh Ramdin lining up for them at the top. And Cottrell, of course, Alzari Joseph, and Riyad Emirates, along with Sohail Tanvir, will be plying their trade with the ball.
Getting an opportunity here to open a batting for the Barbados Tridents. This team looks very different from the team that was selected initially in the draft. No Alex Hills, Marcus Stoinis, Wahab Riaz, Harry Gurney, etc. Johnson Charles, well, he has been there last season as their leading run scorer. 415 runs for him with a high score of 58. And he would want to replicate, if not better, that performance in 2020.
And now we're ready for action. Warm welcome to everyone, wherever you are in the world. Second game of the opening day's doubleheader. Knight Riders already wrapping up their contest against the Amazon Warriors. Look for the swing of Sohail Tanvir. Off the mark straight away, the Tridents. Close, close, must be close. Almost an LLBW. Five without loss after one.
Let's look at this decision from umpire Nigel Duguid. If anything, it will be the height that will come into question there. And the benefit going to the batsman.
Lights on, Cottrell strikes. That is bang down the line of the off stump. It's an ugly shot from Charles, but the soldier celebrates.
And the first wicket for the man from Jamaica representing the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots. You miss, I hit. Bang on target, and off goes that off stump. Not the best looking shots there from Johnson Charles, and look at that celebration. El Dorado celebration, one that we've become used to from the soldier, and pure elation for him. First strike, St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots. Johnson Charles, he goes for 4, 8 for 1.
Corey Anderson. A calling card left now by Sheldon Cottrell on the grill of the New Zealand international.
Bang on target. What a first delivery to get on your helmet. Just zeroing in on that target there from Sheldon Cottrell. The medical staff will be called upon just to ensure that concussion rule is taken care of.
Got him, another one. Struck on the head, and then the next ball punched to Evan Lewis at point. A disappointing start to a CPL journey for Corey Anderson.
And the Patriots are on fire here at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy. Two wickets in the over, in the opening over from Sheldon Cottrell. really setting things back for the Patriots. The first ball on his head, the second one just outside off stump, and a neat catch at point. Corey Anderson has to go without troubling the scorers. Evan Lewis gleefully accepts that one, and the second wicket goes for the Tridents, 8 for 2.
This could be one, this could be that wicket. Evan Lewis underneath it, and hope is gone.
Well, there might still be some hope for the Tridents, but Shea Hope, the wicket dismissed. So El Tanver into the act, and following up on that double wicket over from Sheldon Cottrell. Really an uncalled, an unnecessary decision here from Shea Hope, having lost two wickets in the previous over. Taking on Sohail Tanver, bringing about his demise. Evan Lewis made that catch look simple, and Shea Hope goes for 3. Tridents now in further trouble at 8 for the loss of 3 wickets.
Tridents captain, the giant figure of Jason Holder. Nice stroke. Goes hard at it, goes all the way. A hero maximum, the first of this match.
Shot boy. Just stand and deliver from Kyle Myers in the slot. And a good whack straight over the bowler's head. And a good catch in the deep as well from Mitchell Santner. Republic Bank Classic, look at that catch. Well done, Mitch Santner.
Riyad Emirates should have done better. And that is lovely composure and balance in the shot.
Back-to-back boundaries here for Kyle Myers. First to 6, following it up with a 4. A disappointing effort from the captain in the covers. Should have done better, as Bish mentioned. And as a bowler, always disappoints. Tridents cheerleaders, well, they're having a time.
Instead, he gives him with the, how stylish is that? There was a hallmark of high quality about that shot. Well, all 3 of them.
Dutty here from Kyle Myers, 6-4-4. This time with an offer. And absolutely smashed by Kai Myers. That one absolutely raced to the boundary in lightning time. So under pressure here now, like I mentioned, this strategy might not work. It isn't working.
Still got one ball left. Still got one. 1 for 16 won't be bad. Better length to finish the over. Entertainment galore. 30 for 3 after 5.
Jason Holder to face. That's gone. Picked it up nicely. Good timing. That's the sort of shots you want to see in the power play. Beautifully picked up. Long boundary. Dragged it short into Holder's hip and just flicks it over backward square. It's a real warm-up length that you just cannot afford to stray with any of your deliveries. You've only got 24 if you're lucky enough to get the 4 overs. Short and gone again. Goes all the way. Didn't look like it would have the distance. But confirmation from the umpire. Another hero maximum. It's just this length, isn't it? Just sitting up on this surface. It's not quick when it's banged in. And again. Well, it's raining boundaries here. The Patriots under some pressure after taking early control of this innings. Another hero maximum.
Yeah, Joseph's having a great deal of difficulty just settling into the right line and length. This is a massive turnaround. The Tridents were on the canvas. Three down for not many. Now, suddenly, they're back in this contest, if not ahead of this contest.
Rule is with the ball. Nice clean strike by Jason Holder, the captain. Well, he's joining the party. A life boy clean strike by the Tridents captain.
It's a lovely stroke to bring up the 50 partnership. Again, Sodi not looking to turn the ball. He hasn't got the confidence with that ball. And Jason Holder, he's a tall, tall man. He's got long levers and just hits straight through the line.
Nice clean shot again. It goes all the way. He makes it look so easy, Jason Holder.
Again, not looking to overhit the ball. Striking it. His head down. And placing it. There's a big gap between deep mid off and deep mid on, and he found it.
Straight to the fielder, Jamar Hamilton. And that's wicket number 150 to Riyad Emirat in T20 cricket.
Man, just absolutely smoked that. Flat to deep cover. He'd have to consider himself unlucky. He's middled that perfectly, but he's picked out the one fielder at deep cover, went straight to him. He didn't have to move an inch. The wicket they needed, though, the Patriots, to get back into this contest. A brilliant knock from Mayers. He goes for 37 off 20. It's 69 for 4.
Jonathan Carter, the hero in the final in 2019 of the match.
Direct hit. The Patriots, they're celebrating. This will be interesting.
Evan Lewis, take a bow. This is brilliant. Awareness of backward point. We quite often see Lewis stationed out in the outfield because he's a very good outfielder, but he's sitting in the critical position of backward point. Swoops on it and strikes. Look at that. That is brilliant fielding. And talk about a comeback. This game is seesawing.
My word. How quickly things can change in a T20 match. The Patriots, they're showing why they're a good side. Remember, they qualified in the top four in 2019. And again, after an onslaught, able to pull things back with a couple wickets. Brilliance by Evan Lewis to get rid of Jonathan Carter with odd scoring. It's 69 for 5. Helped away. He continues to struggle, Alzari Joseph.
Confidence is shot. That first over has really shook him up. To come back with your first delivery and you come back over dragging it terribly down leg side like that with fine leg up as well.
Finds the fielder. Another good catch. Emirat strikes again. Well, he came in at a tough time when there's a fast bowler. They were going for plenty. And this is his second wicket.
Roman Reefer would be disappointed with that. Shortish delivery. He had all the space on that leg side to heave that ball, and he finds Sheldon Cottrell straight to him to hit him in the chest. It's Celebrations all round. Another wicket for the Patriots. Reefer goes for two. It's 79 for six.
28-year-old Mitch Santana comes to the crease. His team in deep trouble. Should be leg byes. And signaled by the umpire, so the Tridents will take it nonetheless.
Yeah, and when the ball hums across the boundary like that and goes for four, that ball just gets a little bit greasy and a little bit more challenging.
Very difficult for the earth spinners in particular with a wet ball. Difficult to grip, difficult to control, and it doesn't help when your captain misfields as well. Should have done better with that one, Riyad Emirat. Not for the first time.
Bit like that. Dunk was playing those all over Pakistan. Here we are in the Caribbean, and it's Mitch Santana bringing the 100 up for the Tridents here.
This is an uncharacteristic length from Riyad Emirat, a little bit too full. And given the treatment, full and wide, and Mitch Santana, while he's having that any day of the week. And this one is pulled away. Will it be taken? Yes, it is taken. Ben Gunk, the man in the deep, makes no mistake with that one. So a short delivery and bringing the wicket, the downfall of the captain, Jason Holder.
Ah, funky dunky. Marvellous pair of hands here. Yeah, more of a thick edge. Look at that. He's almost taking it behind him in the presence of mind just to halt nicely with the balance. It takes some doing, I can tell you. Holder, got to go for 38 from 22, and the Tridents lose their seventh now at 101. Of Ashley Nunes, other side of 30 these days. Pretty clean, in fact, clean enough to go for four. Santner, very crisp indeed. It ends the over, the 13th, 106 for seven.
Excellent bit of timing here from Mitch Santner, just over pitching and press back past him.
Can you believe it? Guess who's got in the way? Chris Lynn and the haircut. 100. Not the greatest delivery going around, but I tell you, when you've got fielders like Dunk and Lynn in your side, anything's possible. What a cracker.
Yeah, very unfortunate here for the Barbados Tridents. Ashley Nurse would have felt that he got enough of that to go to the boundary. Instead, Chris Lynn was in the way. And a wonderful catch from the Australian. Let's look at this shot. Swiveling on it. A good enough connection. But straight to Chris Lynn. And Ashley Nurse, well, he has to go another wicket for the Barbados Tridents. He goes for four. 116 for eight.
Very useful, the Rashid Khan coming in at number 10 for your lineup. Oh, talk about some wrist work. He's fatted his first one. Hero Maximum. Take that, Alzari Joseph.
Simply sensational here from Rashid Khan. The first delivery against the big fast bowler, Alzari Joseph. And look at that. As easy as you'd like. Just a hockey flick there from Rashid Khan. Magnificent wrists from the man from Afghanistan, and having some fun. Look at that smile.
That is soft. Riyad Emirat holds on to it. And Walsh Jr. will get his chance.
I mentioned the Tridents picking fielders, not having the opposition work for their wickets. This is another example. Have a look at this. Length delivery, if he placed it to the left or right, he would have gotten runs.
but straight to Riyad Emirates. It's been the story of the day with the bat for the Tridents. Santner goes for 20, 128 for 9 now.
Walsh Jr. arrives at the crease. Still with 3.5 overs left in the inning, so let's see if common sense can prevail and they can survive.
They give out Stuart Williams with the St. Lucia Zooks.
Timing there was superb from Rashid Khan. There seemed to be very little backflip or follow through. Used the pace brilliantly.
As we've mentioned and as we've seen in that first match, pace on the ball makes it very easy to get your timing right. Doesn't really have to muscle the ball, Rashid Khan. Does it to perfection. Welcome boundary for the Tridents.
That's very good. That is superb from Rashid Khan. Still now past 150, so for all the travails, particularly early up with this batting lineup, it's a score to work with now.
Again, reinforces the depth in this Trident's batting lineup. That's really good thinking. Very versatile, unorthodox in his approach, but effective, Rashid Khan.
So they survive. The Tridents, they utilize every delivery of their innings. In trouble very early on with 3 wickets down for 9. But Rashid Khan has played a decent hand, 26 from 4. And they've given themselves something to work with at 153 for 9 off their 20 overs. Charles went early to an ugly shot. Anderson was hit on the helmet and then caught a point by Lewis. Next ball off the bowling of Cottrell. Hope played a very rough stroke as well. But Kyle Mayers looked good for 37. Jason Holder, promoting himself up the order, also looked in very, very good touch. Mitch Santner, well, he may get much more batting throughout this tournament.
That significant partnership was essential for the Trident. 61 between Mayers and Holder. The next best was 25. That last wicket partnership, which propelled the Tridents to 153.
2 wickets for Sohail Tanvir. Both himself and Cottrell were quite good early up until Tanvir maybe had one over too many. 2 wickets for Cottrell, good throughout, and a couple for Riyad Emirates, the captain. Good figures, 2 for 16.
Well, the Patriots, they will require 154 of 20 overs. We'll take a short break and we'll come back with second half action.
Dennis Ramden made the move from TKR to the Patriots. It's been a big, big pickup for the Patriots. The experience he offers, very fine keeper, also an experienced batsman who'll give them stability in the middle order.
Just slipping. As he just a little bit of nibble, what outrageous pace. Start Lynn was looking for. Nice little freebie to get off the mark with that one.
Yeah, an absolute gift. Early in innings, just to get that little half volley that drifts down the leg side. And you have to just get a little bit of bat on it. There is a fine leg in place, but not that fine.
Like for, isn't it? That's a beautiful little line and length. It's going to cost him 4, so unlucky the bowler.
Yeah, speaking of that third man, have been nice to have had him there, because certainly would have prevented a boundary. Not intentional from Lindis. A genuine outside edge, pushing forward. Better line, though, from Mayers. More that fourth off stump line, particularly if he's looking to push the ball into the stumps.
Sacrifice the third man for a long on. Another area for Lynn is so productive. Even though he's brought up in Brisbane and there's good surfaces there, moves the Gabba, slides on under lights there too. That's that line. Ball is going to get damp across that outfield as it runs into the boundary cushion. Another one of those leg side boundaries to Chris Lynn.
Oh, you've got to catch those. Hayden Walsh Jr., after a great partnership with Rashid Khan, grasses this opportunity. And he'll be very frustrated because he is a good fielder. He would have expected to gobble that up. Just completely misjudged. I think he felt it came to him a lot quicker than he expected.
This will zip across the outfield for Lewis. Bit of a carve on the onside, but the result for him, a good one.
He's got protection on the leg side. It's always difficult for a spinner in the power play overs. Just the two back, but not one behind square. There is one in front of square and a deep mid on. Hence, Santner looking to bowl. Very much a leg stump line.
I think that batter can chase it on. I think the score is gettable. And, you know, once we get a batter, it stays into the hand. We have got enough quality players that can sort of help us out.
Well, we've had the first one go down. Thank you, Courtney Walsh. Talking there to Alex Jordan, it's Chris Lynn. He's trying to carve one across cover point and has come second and he's got to go.
Well, it's the matchup. The left arm spin of Santner against Lynn has worked a treat for the Tridents. Just the line cramping Lynn and also a little bit of extra bounce, and Hayden Walsh Jr. making no error with that one. It's a big wicket. Lynn goes for 19. It's 30 for 1.
Young Joshua De Silva, only 22 years of age. His first ever T20 game.
Just pulling down on that one, and this one finds the gap. Despite a brilliant effort in the deep, the short ball first up and got the treatment.
Pulling it down, Rashid Khan doesn't get his length right, and Evan Lewis, he's been there from the start, bounces on it.
Chance for a run out there, maybe. Evan Lewis is very quick. I think he was in control of the ball at this moment. Contact with the stumps. The ball is now dislodged. Look at this here. Ball on the stumps. Yes, that's good enough. This will be out. This will be run out. Evan Lewis goes. The first wicket down. Sorry, the second wicket, beg your pardon, down for the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots, and a dangerous Evan Lewis. A wonderful job there from Rashid Khan. And an unfortunate way to be dismissed. Run out at the non-striker's end. But for Evan Lewis, a dangerous Evan Lewis. He goes for 12. Patriots now with 39 for 2.
Ben Dunk has his opportunity with the bat. Has definitely weakened the batting of this Patriots team. That should and might be a boundary. The umpire will want to check again. There was a bit of a fumble there from Santner.
So they want to have a closer look at that just to make sure. What do you reckon, Darren?
Let's just have a look at that left leg. contact with the advertising board and contact with the hand as well. Just there. That should be four.
The icon could four runs. Let's see the signal there. Fire. He concludes as well.
I'm going to try and keep ahead of the game, so to speak. Keep showing your variations. Keep working on the accuracy and consistency. Nice shot. Really good shot. Good use of the depth of the crease to try and get that length. Then muscles it through the offside.
A good placement and timing here from Ben Donk. Just fractionally on the shorter side. Quickly onto it, and the key thing there was finding the gap.
Just gets it past the fielder there at mid-off. Was a lofted shot, the timing was good, and it's a good result for the Patriots.
Yeah, just over pitching there and giving the width. Raymond Reefer and Ben Donk is too good a player to miss out on that occasion. The mid-off up is always going to be risky. And getting the reward, Ben Donk. He certainly would want to just squeeze in these overs here, the Tridents. Minimize the number of boundaries that are scored. But the experience of Ben Donk.
This is a first hero maximum for the Patriots. Eight previous fours, and this one goes flying over the boundary line. What a shot!
And the first maximum comes off the bat of Ben Donk. And short on this occasion, and hammered over deep mid-wicket. Not enough pace to trouble anyone, Raymond Reefer.
In the gap. And that's a most welcome boundary for the Patriots and for Joshua De Silva, 80 for 2 after 11.
To get onto this very, very quickly, which he does. Gets back and pulls it away through straight mid-wicket. Great power. Seen so many batsmen lose their stumps trying to do pretty much the same as that.
Good touch. Almost got caught napping. Joshua De Silva, I think they might have a look at the boundary check or the run out, or both. Can't tell from that angle either. Silva status quo will remain if we do not get a conclusive angle that confirms or not whether he touched the boundary. And if he hasn't, we look at the run out. Safely home. Appropriate use of technology by the officials.
Yeah, and if you think it's bad for Samuel Badri, oh, well, this one is high up in the air. Someone's underneath it. And it's taken. It's a wicket.
It is a wicket. Kyle Myers takes a catch there. Mitch Santner, he gets the breakthrough. Ben Donk, the man dismissed, going for a hero maximum, pulling out in the deep. So it's a breakthrough that the Barbados Tridents needed, and a good time to get it as well. The well-set Ben Donk, he perishes. And a wicket here for Mitch Santner, brought back into the attack just for this very reason. And a simple catch, but at least it looks simple, from Kyle Myers. And the third wicket goes for the Patriots, 89 for 3.
A major breakthrough.
Dinesh Ramdin, a new batsman for the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots.
in the gap. Most welcome because he was 19 from 24 and falling behind the silver in the tempo. Now nearly a run of all 100 comes up.
Yeah, very good. It's the second four. He's played off the back foot off Rashid Khan. This one a little bit shorter, so it just sat up a bit more. A lot easier for him to put away. Rashid Khan is clearly having his troubles, like all spinners, in gripping the ball. Heavy dew there.
Onto the pull shot again. And that's my before. I think he touched it while he was on the ropes, Jonathan Carter. And he recognizes it now.
It's a good effort to begin with, but he just was concerned it was going to roll back in, but he was rolling out at the same time. So there it is, the elbow just touches it. So that'll be a boundary and a welcome one to finish the over. 10 coming from it. It's 109 for three.
Bit of luck.
Oh, great gallant effort, but he might have palmed it away for four, has he?
Oh, not quite. Rashid Khan tidies up. It's a wonderful effort to get there, even get there, really.
I'm with you, Danny Morrison. Let's have a look at this. Old stretch arm, Ashley Nurse. Just couldn't hold on. It had to stick. Luckily for the Tridents, Rashid Khan was able to save his team a run.
Yeah, he's quick, Rashid Khan. Young legs.
Rammed him with a slog sweep. Has he got enough? No, you're kidding. He hasn't got enough. Walsh. Republic Bank Classic catch. We've seen some goodies tonight. Darren Ganga.
Well, he allowed us to question his ability on the field. Hayden Walsh Jr. when he dropped a straightforward catch off the bat of Evan Lewis. But since then, he's made amends. That's his second catch of the match. Hayden Walsh Jr., look at this. Athletic, efficient, proficient. Absolute brilliance. That's quality. That's the standard that Jason Holder will expect from his teammates. And it has accounted for Dinesh Ramdin. Gone for 13, it's 124 for 4.
Oh, knocked him over there. It is the wrong of Jamar Hamilton. It's going to be in and out. Just like that. He's on a hat-trick now as Rashid Khan.
In a matter of a couple balls, he can change the game. That's a big value from this man, Rashid Khan. It's the wrong on. He doesn't pick it. Jamar Hamilton. And with the drier ball, Rashid Khan is a different bowler. Wicket number five for the Tridents. Hamilton goes without scoring. 124 for five.
Hat-trick time.
Oh, cricket guru stats. Fans out there know that he has already had a hat-trick at this venue 3 years ago for Guyana against the Jamaica Tullowars, and he was spot on there, targeting the poles. Not to be. Long handle. Enough on it, you betcha. There's a much-needed boundary for the Patriots.
So Tanvir, he's done it very often, played that cameo that has contributed significantly to the success of his franchise team, the Warriors, when he played for them. Now he's with the Patriots. Can he do the same?
Missed out again here. Oh, it's a noble, went that height, waist high. Oh, wait. Thought about coming back, but there's the call. So we've got a freebie, Darren Ganga. Get that helicopter shot out.
This is a strange game, Danny Morrison. 18 required from 5 deliveries now. That includes
a free hit.
Skipper got out and Santner got out. It was up to Rashid Khan.
Oh, too little too late. What a shame. We needed this a couple of overs ago. Yeah, it's a hero maximum. What a shame. That was a clean strike. Only the second hero maximum for the Patriots. It comes off the bat of Sohail Tanvir. Little too late. 8 required from the last delivery.
Yeah, what a shame. In terms of creating more drama, because 8's required and has to be another extra. And ideally a freebie, DG, but yeah.
Patriots fans will be hoping for Mayers to overstep, possibly. Give them a free hit, maybe an extra delivery.
No, he doesn't. He does well here as the bowler, Kyle Mayers. So after 20, they fall half a dozen short. Do the Patriots. 147 for 5. Very pleased. Trident's dugout. So match 2. Patriots trying to track down that 154. Fell a little short in the end. But, top order there. Would have loved a bit more from Lynn Lewis and Dunk. Dunk got set, got going into the 30s, but couldn't convert. A dozen extras certainly helps. Yeah, not big enough partnerships. Just that one there of De Silva and Dunk needed to keep going. And then the one with Ramden was cut short with a brilliant catch from Hayden Walsh Jr. out there in the deep. Yeah, just kept stuttering along. Sort of stuck in second gear with the Patriots. 7 bowlers used and mixed around there. Holder will be particularly pleased for the outing for the specialist bowlers. Rashid, a couple, same with Santner, the wicket takers. Certainly, everyone got a bit of a go at the bowling crease. So, in summary, 153 for 9 was good enough. Shouldn't have got there, is what the coach of the Patriots will be saying. 147 for 5, 6 runs short of that target. The Tridents take it out by 6.